Hello dear children, once again I welcome you all to our class, The Rat Trap. In the last class we have seen that a peddler was wandering all around through the road after having stolen the money of the poor crofter. He was unable to walk through the public road as he was afraid of the policeman. So he enters in the forest where he finds to be an impenetrable prison. And he thought that his life is going to end there. Soon he happened to hear the thumping sound that is coming from the nearby iron mill. He focused his attention towards that place and he reached the forge. And because of the surrounding sound, no one sees him as he entered inside the forge. And we see that the forge, there were only two people, the master blacksmith and his helper. Okay. And the peddler entered the forge with rat traps hanging on his chest to warm himself in the night. Okay, so let's take your textbook and see today's portion. He asked permission to stay and the masked blacksmith nodded a haughty consent without honoring him with a single word. The tramp did not say anything either. He had not come there to talk but only to warm himself and sleep. So, once he entered inside the forge, as we see that there were only two people, the master blacksmith as well as his helper, isn't it? So, once the peddler entered inside the room, he asked permission to the blacksmith. Because he was totally wet, it was dripping outside, heavy rain, wind, as well as he spent most of his time in the forest. So, he was so tired also, water was dripping from his coat. So he asked permission whether he could stay inside the forge that night. Because, you know, the furnace, heavy temperature heat is going on, isn't it? And he can just lay beside that to get himself far from the cold situation. Apart from that, it's Christmas season, December month. Okay, so the peddler was given permission. And we see what we see here in the attitude of this master blacksmith is he was not ready to ask anything further. He was not trying to inquire about from where this peddler has come, what is his business, nothing likewise, because that shows a haughty kind of mannerism from the part of this masked blacksmith, because at the first sight itself, he could understand that he just lives a life by begging. And looking at the rat traps that is hanging on his chest also, gave him a haughty consent, because he was not approved. He was not ready to approve the man who entered inside the forge. He was just looking like indecent person and he was not ready to talk to him. Okay. But we see that the tramp or the vagabond was not complaining about that, because his intention was only to rest that night in the forge, to warm himself from the cold, from the dripping wet. Okay. So he never bothered whether someone talked to him. Or the attitude of the blacksmith was not at all bothered by this tramp. He only wanted to rest somewhere in a comfortable place like this. And here he can get enough and more warmth also. Okay. Then in those days, the Ramsgrove iron mill was owned by a very prominent ironmaster, whose greatest ambition was to ship out good iron to the market. He watched both night and day to see that the work was done as well as possible. And at this very moment, he came into the forge on one of his nightly rounds of inspection. So, we see that once this peddler was in this forge, he was warming himself near to the furnace. By the time, we see that the owner of the iron mill comes here. What is the name of the iron mill? It's Ramsgrove. Ramsgrove, it was owned by a prominent ironmaster. Ironmaster here, the owner of the iron mill. He comes here. Because his ambition or his intention in running behind this iron mill is to ship good iron to the market. Already we have seen that there is a forge, there is a smelter, there is a furnace, everything, rolling mill, every setup was here in this mill. So this iron master comes for having a check during the daytimes as well as the nighttime shift. He wanted to see whether the work was going on properly or not. So, this time, today, the day when this peddler was here near to the forge, as a part of his nightly visit, who came here? The master of the iron mill. Okay, the iron master came to have a visit to check whether the work was going on properly or not. Okay, and this day also he came here for the nightly round of inspection. okay, because he wanted to see the work is going on well, as his intention or his wish is to ship good iron to the market. Okay, then naturally the first thing he saw was the tall ragamuffin who had eased his way so close to the furnace that steam rose from his wet rags. The ironmaster did not follow the example of the blacksmith, who had hardly denied to look at the stranger. He walked closer to him, looked him over very carefully, then tore off his gloves, had to get a better view of his face. So here we see that this ironmaster, once he entered inside this iron mill, the first thing that he witnessed here, or first thing that he had seen here, is the man who was lying there. Here it says that he saw the man in ragamuffin. What is ragamuffin? Ragamuffin means a person who is wearing rags. Okay? So he was not wearing proper dress. He was wearing rags, torn rags and all. He was wet. He was lying near the furnace. And here we see that steam was just going on from his clothes because the wet clothes. When heat was just coming closer to him, we can see that water just evaporates from his clothes. So when the ironmaster first noticed the man on rags or ragamuffin who lay near the furnace, he walked closely towards him. And here we see that specifically said that he didn't follow the attitude of the master blacksmith. Why? What is that? We see that this master blacksmith, once he had seen this man in rags, he was not ready to talk with him. Isn't it? So, he saw the peddler in the dark and he just went near to him. He doesn't know who this person is. And unlike the blacksmith, he went very closer to have a closer look at this person. He observed him very closely. And also, he just took off the hat from his face. For what? To have a better view of this person. Okay? So, he's a stranger here. So, definitely, this ironmaster need to know the intention of this man. Or why he is here in the late night. So, he went there. He wanted to know about the stranger. He went there to have a closer look. Okay? But of course, it's you, Nils Olof, he said. How you do look? The man with the rat trap had never before seen the ironmaster as Ramju. And did not even know what his name was. But it occurred to him that if the fine gentleman thought he was an old acquaintance, he might perhaps throw him a couple of kroner. Therefore, he did not want to undeceive him all at once. So what happened here? When the ironmaster went nearer to him, when he saw the peddler in the dark, we see that he mistook this peddler to be one of his old acquaintance. So what he did, he thought that the peddler to be one of his old acquaintance. Who is an acquaintance? Acquaintance is a friend. Okay. So thinking likewise, or a well-known person, a familiar person, thinking likewise, he went near the peddler in the dark light. He mistook him for a person who knows him. Then he calls him with the name Nils Olof. What is it here? He called his name, thinking that he is one of his acquaintances. He said, "Oh, Nils Olof." When the peddler heard this, he was not ready to correct this ironmaster by telling that, "No, you misunderstood me." Nothing like that. Immediately, the peddler thought that, let me be one of his acquaintance. If he sees one of his acquaintance in such a pathetic condition, definitely he will throw me some amount. See, even if after getting trapped, after stealing the money from the crofter, he was not done. He was just thinking about getting more money. So he was not ready to correct the ironmaster by telling that, "No, you mistook me for someone you know." And for the rat trap seller, this is the first time ever in his life that he meets this ironmaster. But he is now pretending like, okay, let him consider me as one of his acquaintance. Silently he accepted whatever said by the ironmaster. Okay, he was not ready to rectify or correct the ironmaster by telling that I am a stranger. I am new to this place. I don't know you. You might have mistaken me for someone else. He didn't utter a word. Okay? So, he just mistook him for an old comrade of his regiment. Then, he was so sad that things had gone downhill with him. And here we see that the peddler was also thinking that, yes, this man is not going to leave me. Likewise, empty-handed, he'll be giving some money to me. Okay? Yes, God knows things have gone downhill with me, he said. He should not have resigned from the regiment, said the ironmaster. That was the mistake. If only I had still been in the service at the time, it would never have happened. Well, now of course you will come home with me. To go along up to the manor house and be received by the owner like an old regimental comrade, that however did not please the tramp. Okay? So now what happens here is, when the ironmaster mistook him for one of his familiar friend, the peddler who was keeping quiet for so long, he thought that, yes, I'm going to get some money from this business. Okay? So what happened? Immediately, the ironmaster felt sympathy for the man, and even the peddler says that, yes, things went. I was facing some hard times. Everything just went, what is that, upside down. You also admit likewise. Now the ironmaster says that nothing would have happened if I was there in the regiment. That shows that this ironmaster was once worked in a regiment, a part of the regiment, old regiment, and he mistook this person for his friend in regiment. And he says that you would have never happened this misfortune in your life if I have not resigned from the job. I would not have happened this to you if I still continue in that regiment. He may be working in army, isn't it? So he might have resigned his job from there. Now he is running an iron mill here. So he feels pity for the condition of the peddler whom he mistook or had mistaken for one of his friend who was in the regiment. And finally, considering him as one of his old comrade, he just invited the peddler to his home. So he said, okay, come, get up, let's go. He invited the peddler to home to go with him. But we see that in this particular moment, this vagabond was not seemed pleased. He said, no, I'm not ready. He seems to be like, it's not a good idea. He only wanted some krona from this ironmaster. That's why he pretended what? Indirectly as one of his friend. Openly he didn't say that I am your friend. Indirectly, silently he accepted whatever said by the ironmaster, thinking that he'll be getting some krona, money. But when the ironmaster invited the peddler to his home, it seems to be like, yes, everything is going out of my control. He find it troublesome to accept the invitation. Why? Because already he had stolen some money from the crofter. It would be like putting himself into more trouble. So he said, no, I am not ready to come there. And he doesn't want to put himself into trouble. Okay? So that's when it says that, no, I couldn't think of it, he said, looking quite alarmed. He thought of the 30 krona. To go up to the manor house would be like throwing himself voluntarily into the lion's den. He only wanted a chance to sleep here in the forge and then sneak away as inconspicuously as possible. So what happened? What we see here is the peddler now immediately says that, no, I'm not ready to come with you. I'm not ready to accept your invitation. I don't want to come to your manor house. Manor house means the bungalow. I don't want to come with you. Because you know that he is not the acquaintance of the ironmaster. Secondly, he has done a mistake. What is that? He had stolen the money from the crofter. So definitely the crofter might have informed the rich people or the higher personalities of that area that his money has lost. The police may be wandering around for the theft. So he thought that it's danger to be in the manor house. Immediately he remembered about the 30 krona. And he thought that if I go with the ironmaster now to his manor house, to his bungalow, it would be like I'm putting myself into a lion's den. I'm just opening or I'm just digging my own grave. I don't want to be in such situation. He said that no, I'm not ready to come. Let me spend my night here. My only wish is to spend the night here. And he doesn't have anything else. Okay? So, and also here he says that he wanted to sneak away. That means the next morning after spending the night in the forge, comfortably. He wanted to sneak away. Sneak away means he wanted to go away silently, inconspicuously. That means without getting noticed. He doesn't want to get noticed by others. That such a person just lives here. Such a person spent his night here in the forge. And the very morning, early morning itself, he wanted to leave the place. He already done a mistake. He doesn't want to put himself into more trouble. Okay, that's why he insisted to stay in the forge himself. And he just denied the invitation of the Iron Master to his manor house. Actually, the Iron Master mistook this person for one of his comrades in the regiment, in the army. This peddler, who indirectly accepted the relation which was said by the Iron Master, refuses later to visit his manor house because he doesn't want to put himself into more trouble. Okay? The Iron Master assumed that he felt embarrassed because of his miserable clothing. "Please don't think that I have such a fine home that you cannot show yourself there," he said. "Elizabeth is dead. As you may already have heard, my beaux are abroad and there is no one at home except my oldest daughter and myself. We were just saying that it was too bad we didn't have any company for Christmas. Now come along with me and help us make the Christmas food disappear a little faster." Okay? So here we see that once the Iron Master reached the iron mill, when he saw this peddler, he mistook this person for whom? Person for one of his comrades. And that's one of the reason why he just called him what? Nils Olof, isn't it? He walked very close to the peddler and he asked whether it's you, Nils Olof. How do you look like? And also we see that he mistook him for an old comrade. But we see that the peddler had never seen the Iron Master. He didn't know even his name. And the peddler didn't say anything because he hoped and expected for some money. When the Iron Master invited this peddler to the manor house, he was not interested. He thought like it was just putting himself into a lion's den. What was the reason? Because he had stolen the money from the crofter's house. And if someone comes to know about this, his life will be in danger. So he thought that he was throwing himself voluntarily into a lion's den. So he refused to go. By the time, the Iron Master thought that it's all because he has got miserable clothing. He was not looking quite well, okay? And also the appearance, very sympathetic look. And also some rat traps were dangling all over his chest and all. So this demeanor of this peddler might have created a sort of inferiority in him. So that may be one of the reasons why he was not ready. So he says that Iron Master was again trying to convince this peddler and he was trying to persuade him to take him his home by telling that, "Don't worry, there is no one in my house, only myself and my oldest daughter. My elder daughter is there, only we two are there. Even, you know, my wife already dead. The name of his wife is Elizabeth. My wife has dead. She has died. And what about my sons? They are working abroad. So no one there, only me and my oldest daughter. So don't get ashamed of how you look or what you are now. There is no one. You can just come." Okay? And also says that we'll be very happy because if you come with us. And also we were very sad for not having a special guest during this Christmas season. You know that people are very much interested to have guests during Christmas because Christmas is a time for charity too. So here, this is the greatest time for this Iron Master and his family to do a favor and a charitable work towards this peddler. So that's where it says that, "Please come with me and make our Christmas feast disappear soon." That means help us to finish our Christmas. Help us join in our Christmas feast. Feast is, what is that? A very sumptuous, delicious food items. Okay, so anyhow, this Iron Master with great happiness, he is inviting one of his old regimental friend. Considering this peddler to be one of his old regimental friend, he is just persuading this person by telling that only we two people are there in a home. Okay, anyhow, the Iron Master decided that, "However, I'll take this man to my house." Okay, then. But the stranger said, "No, no, and no again." And the Iron Master saw that he must give in. "It looks as though Captain Wandsdale preferred to stay with you tonight, St. Johnstone," he said to the master blacksmith and turned on his heel. But he laughed to himself as he went away, and the blacksmith, who knew him, understood very well that he had not said his last word. So here it says that when the ironmaster was persuading this man to go along with him, we see that this stranger or this tramp was not ready to go with him. He said, no, I'm not ready. Whatever you say, whether there is no one else other than you and your oldest daughter, whoever may be there, he doesn't care. He only said that, no, I am not ready to come there. He was unhappy to accept the invitation of the Iron Master. So anyhow, Iron Master understood one thing, that whatever I say or however I just spend my time persuading this person, he is not ready to come, because he has made up his mind not to go along. So he thought that, okay, let me withdraw. Okay, let me just move away. Okay, let him stay here. And what happened? Once the Iron Master accepted his failure of taking this man towards his manor or his bungalow, he looks at the Master Blacksmith. The name of the Master Blacksmith is said here, Sendinstong. Okay, so here we see that this Master Blacksmith, who knows this Iron Master very well, he understood one thing. Yes. Already, this Iron Master said that, I think that Captain Wonstail is the name of the captain whom which this peddler was mistaken to. Okay. So, anyhow, Iron Master said that, I think our Captain Wonstail preferred to stay with St. John Storm, that is the blacksmith, in the forge tonight. So, let me go. Okay. When he said this, Master Blacksmith was very clear about one thing, that the Iron Master didn't give up. That means, however, if he had taken a decision, he will accomplish it at any cost. What was the decision taken by the Iron Master? To take the peddler to his home. Okay? So he'll find another way. So the Iron Master went from the mill, accepting his defeat for the time being in front of the peddler. But the Master Blacksmith was pretty sure that he will find another way to take this man to his house. Okay, then. It was not more than half an hour before they heard the sound of carriage wheels outside the forge, and a new guest came in. But this time it was not the Iron Master. He had sent his daughter, apparently hoping that she would have better powers of persuasion than he himself. So here what happened? This time, after the Iron Master went, half an hour later, the Master Blacksmith heard the sound of a carriage. Okay, the horse cart or the vehicle in which a lady came there. And this time, it was not whom? It was not the Iron Master. But this time, here we see the daughter of the Iron Master came here. The name of the daughter is Etla. Etla Wilmanson. Okay. And the Master Blacksmith, for sure, he was expecting this arrival of this Etla here. Actually, she was sent by whom? Sent by the Iron Master. Okay? Iron Master know that ladies have some sort of persuasive power. What is persuasive power? They know how to tactfully talk with another person and bring him to their home. Okay? So, the power of persuasion for a lady is much more higher than that of a man. Okay, that may be one of the reason why Iron Master thought of sending his daughter Etla to persuade this man, to force this person to go along with Etla to their manor house. Okay, so here we see that who comes here to take this man to their home? Etla. Etla is the daughter of Iron Master. Okay, so then she entered, followed by a valet carrying on his arm a big fur coat. She was not at all pretty, but seemed modest and quite shy. In the forge, everything was just as it had been earlier in the evening. The Master Blacksmith and his apprentice still sat on the bench, and iron and charcoal still glowed in the furnace. The stranger had stretched himself out of the floor and lay with a piece of pig iron under his head and his hat pulled down over his eyes. As soon as the girl caught the sight of him, she went up and lifted his hat. The man was evidently used to sleeping with one eye open. He jumped up abruptly and seemed to be quite frightened. So, here, who comes here? Etla Wilmanson comes here. And she came with a valet. Valet means an assistant or a servant, because they are rich, no? They live in a manor house. So, to assist this lady, there was a helper boy. Okay. So, he comes with a fur coat. What is that fur coat? Fur coat is in order to protect himself from, oneself from cold. Okay. Just like a sweater, blanket, likewise. Okay. With a cloth made with the skin of animals, sheep and all. Okay. Okay. So, likewise, this assistant or this helper is having a fur coat in his hand. Definitely, that is for whom? That is for the peddler. Because peddler already he was wearing what? Worn clothes. And he was already wet. He was just struggling with a lot of cold, chilling climate. Isn't it? So, that's why he was lying very near to where? Near to the forge. Okay. So, this time this lady comes here. To invite whom? To invite the peddler towards the home for Christmas. And now talking about the lady, here it says that even though she was not looking very pretty or very beautiful, she was pretty enough. That is, altogether she looks, she has got the elegance of being a rich lady. Okay. And also she has got some good qualities in her life too. Okay. So she comes there with polite, with more modest and in an elegant manner, keeping the dignity and serenity of being the daughter of an iron master from a rich family. Okay, she comes with the help of a assistant or a servant. What is that? Holding the fur coat. So once they entered inside the forge, here it seems to be like everything is same when, like, just like when the iron master came here. Here we know that the master blacksmith as well as his assistant was sitting and assisting or trying to do their business there. And she was just looking all around. Immediately, she caught the sight of a man who was lying on the floor. Okay. So, she straight away went towards this man who was lying on the floor. Okay. Who was there lying on the floor? The peddler. Okay. Now, the peddler was lying on the floor with an iron pick to support his leg. Okay. Because he was lying there in order to get some sleep or protect himself from the cold atmosphere. Okay. And as he was lying there, the manner of his sleep, how's it? He used to sleep with one eye open. See, this is how he used to sleep. And also, as he was lying there, he covered his face with the hat. Okay. And when Etla entered inside the forge, all of a sudden, when she noticed the position of this man very near to the furnace, she walked straight away towards the furnace. When she reached there, what she did? She took the hat. Actually, how he used to sleep, this peddler? With one eye open. So, when she took the hat, this peddler was, what is that? He was frightened. Abruptly, he stood up. Okay? All of a sudden, it was unexpected for the peddler that this lady comes there, isn't it? So, what happened? Immediately, he just woke up and he stood. Okay? Then, stood up to see what's going to happen. Okay? Actually, this Etla came here to persuade this peddler. I think we can stop here for today and let's continue some portion in the next class also. So, what we have seen here is the arrival of whom? Arrival of Etla Vilmanson. Etla Vilmanson is the daughter of the Iron Master. Actually, the Iron Master just sent her to this forge in order to take this man towards their house to celebrate Christmas together. To do a charitable work towards this peddler, considering him to be one of his old comrade. Okay, let's see whether she can persuade in the next class or not. Okay, that's for today's class. Thank you all. Have a great day.